हेलो फ्रेंड्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वेलकम अप ऑल ऑफ यू इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ 12th कॉमर्स इकोनॉमिक्स। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आई जस्ट रिवाइज्ड व्हाट वी स्टडीड इन प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर। फ्रॉम द लास्ट टू प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी स्टार्ट 3B or second part of third topic, that is 3B, elasticity of demand. So far up to this video lecture we studied meaning of elasticity, definitions of elasticity of demand. Then we start types of elasticity of demand. We completed two types, cross elasticity of demand and income elasticity of demand. So the next type of elasticity of demand is price elasticity of demand. According to Professor Alfred Marshall, price elasticity of demand is a ratio of proportionate change in the quantity demanded. Proportionate change in the quantity demanded of a commodity to a given proportionate change in its price. To the given proportionate change in price means how to calculate price elasticity, what is meant by price elasticity. With relation to the change in price, listen carefully, with relation to the change in price, how much percentage or in how much proportion the quantity demanded changes is known as a price elasticity of demand. Means percentage change, elasticity of demand is equal to, or price elasticity of demand is equal to, percentage change in quantity demanded divided by percentage change in price. Percentage change in quantity demanded divided by percentage change in price. Symbolically, how we write the formula of price elasticity of demand? Percentage change, this delta stands for change. This delta stands for change, and Q, that is quantity demanded. Q, that is quantity demanded. Next, percentage change in price, that is delta P. So elasticity of demand is equal to delta Q upon Q divided by delta P upon P. This triangle or delta shows change in price or change in quantity demanded. Then delta Q upon Q into original price, that is P, original price, that is P, divided by delta P, that is change in price, delta P, that is change in price. So in this given formula, Q is the original quantity demanded. Delta Q or triangle Q is equal to difference between new quantity and original quantity, that is which shows the change in quantity demanded. New quantity minus original quantity, new quantity minus original quantity, P, that is original price, and delta P, that is difference between new price and original price. So price elasticity of demand means how much in percentage, in ratio, in proportion? The demand changes in respect of percentage change in price, in respect of percentage change in price. Next, types of price elasticity of demand. First type, perfectly elastic demand. Perfectly elastic demand. When a slight change or zero change or the change which is not measurable in the price of the commodity brings an infinite change, amaryadit change, infinite change in the quantity demanded of that commodity, in the quantity demanded of that commodity, it is called as perfectly elastic demand. When a slight change or the change which is not measurable, slight change or zero change, or the change which is not measurable, change which is not measurable in the price of the commodity brings an infinite change, brings an infinite change in quantity demanded of that commodity, it is called as a perfectly elastic demand. Listen carefully. So this concept, it is only a theoretical concept. This concept, it is only a theoretical concept. For example, means this concept is not in practical use. For example, 10% fall in price may lead to infinite rise in demand. 10% fall in price may raise to infinite rise in demand. So in this diagram, on y-axis we show price, on x-axis quantity demanded. So this line shows, which I draw here, original quantity demanded, original quantity demanded. And this is a change because of slight change or zero change or the change which is not measurable in the price. The quantity demanded may be rise or fall, that is infinite change in quantity demanded, which shows by these dotted lines. So in this case, demand curve is horizontal line. This is an horizontal line parallel to x-axis, parallel to x-axis, indicating perfectly elastic demand, indicating perfectly elastic demand. So demand curve is horizontal straight line parallel to x-axis, indicating perfectly elastic demand. Horizontal line, demand curve is horizontal line parallel to the x-axis, indicating perfectly elastic demand. So in this diagram, on y-axis we show price, on x-axis quantity demanded. Quantity demanded. On y-axis we show price, on x-axis we show quantity demanded. P is the original price or price. On y-axis we show price, on x-axis quantity demanded. Q is the quantity demanded of commodity. but due to slight change or zero change or the change in the price which is not measurable in the price, which leads to infinite change, maybe rise or fall in the quantity demanded, that is infinite change in quantity demanded, known as perfectly elastic demand curve. And in this case, demand curve is parallel to x-axis. Demand curve is parallel to x-axis horizontal line. Next, perfectly inelastic demand. Perfectly inelastic demand, or EDE, elasticity of demand, is equal to zero when a percentage change in price has no effect on the quantity demanded. When the percentage change in price has no effect on the quantity demanded of the commodity is called as a perfectly inelastic demand. For example, if 20% fall in the price of the commodity, but there is no change in the quantity demanded of the commodity, known as perfectly inelastic demand, or elasticity of demand in such case is equal to zero. Symbolically or formula, that is percentage change this triangle or delta shows change in quantity demanded and change in price. This example put in formula, ED is equal to percentage change in quantity demanded is zero when percentage change in price is 20%. So elasticity of demand is equal to zero. In practice, such a situation rarely occurs. For example, demand for salt, demand for milk, okay. So perfectly inelastic demand, when a percentage change in price has no effect on the quantity demanded of the commodity. Percentage change in price has no effect on the quantity demanded of a commodity. It is called as perfectly inelastic demand. For example, 20% fall in price will have no effect on quantity demanded. That is, percentage change in price in this example shows, in price shows 20% and quantity demanded affected zero. So such concept is, such situation is rarely occurs in practical in case of necessary goods like salt, milk. Okay, if there is change in the price of salt or milk, salt and milk, maybe there is rise in the price of salt and milk, or maybe there is fall in the price of salt and milk, you cannot buy more quantity of the commodity or less quantity of the commodity. You buy only up to the quantity which you require for your daily need. So it is known as perfectly inelastic demand. This concept rarely occurs in reality. So in this diagram, P is the original price. When price changes or price rises from P to P1, there is no effect on quantity demanded. And when price falls from P to P2, there is again no effect on quantity demanded. So elasticity of demand is equal to zero. And in such case, when a price rises, vertical straight line. In such case, the demand curve is vertical straight line parallel to y-axis. Vertical straight line parallel to y-axis. And in case of perfectly elastic demand, horizontal straight line. Horizontal line parallel to x-axis. And in perfectly inelastic demand, demand curve is parallel to y-axis straight line. On y-axis we show price, on x-axis quantity demanded. P is the original price. When price changes from P to P1 or rises from P to P1, there is no effect on quantity demanded. And when price falls from P to P2, there is again no effect on quantity demanded. So it is known as perfectly inelastic demand. And demand curve is vertical straight line parallel to y-axis. Vertical straight line parallel to y-axis. And E, elasticity of demand, is equal to zero. For example, the example which I show here, okay, percentage change in price is rupees 20. Percentage change in price is rupees 20, but there is no effect on quantity demanded of commodity, that is zero effect. For today, I stop here. After watching this video, you have to write down concept of price elasticity of demand with proper explanation, formula, and symbolical explanation of symbolical formula. Then you have to write down all types of price elasticity of demand and send me up to after you are completing the homework.